Today's video is sponsored by Viter Energy, Viter Mints. Help keeping Cayman awake for those long road trips and drives. Caffeine infused mints. So today, now that I have a Autopilot 2 enabled Model X, and I finally got my first software update since picking this car up 3 weeks ago. Apparently, you don't get them anymore if you're not connected to Wi-Fi, unless it's a very important, security or major safety update. So I finally connected this bugger up to my Wi-Fi at home, and a half hour later, I had an update. And we got 2019.8.4, nice and fresh off the presses. Let's back up a little bit and see what the release notes say. Now, originally it said nothing, and I found out just yet more firmware 9 bugs. I had to restart the screens, and even then, it took about 5 minutes for the release notes to load. Not too impressed yet. And so far, my already very negative thoughts about firmware 9 have been getting worse. But there are some new additions that benefit Autopilot 2 and up-related vehicles. We have auto steer stop light warning. Well, your car may warn you in some cases if it detects that you are about to run a red light while auto steer is in use. This is not a substitute for attentive driver and will not stop the car. So basically, if you're on autopilot on a city street or exiting the freeway and the car detects that you have not yet attempted to slow down or disengage autopilot, it will alert us. And once this video is done, I'm going to be heading out and filming two more videos. At least one will be testing auto steer stoplight warning, and another one we'll be doing navigate by autopilot, and I got a perfect road to show you guys to test that on. Next, dog mode. So I did not have dog mode until this release, even though the software that was on here when I picked up the car 3 weeks ago was only a day old. It was just loaded on the day before. But dog mode keeps your dog comfortable in your car while letting people passing by know they don't need to worry with dog mode. Long story short, because I don't think I need to read the whole darn thing. You guys can read it yourself. Long story short, this is the HVAC Keep Alive. So basically, the Keep Alive function for your heating or air conditioning or just vent, with the addition that the screen... with the screen will stay... will show... And it's not going to do that, is it? All right, I got to remove my microphone here. Let's make the car think that I am no longer in it. There we go. My owner will be back soon. Don't worry. The heater is on and it's 78 degrees Fahrenheit inside. Although I do have it set a little higher than that. And it even disables the screen, so if Poochie's in the car, Poochie's not going to be playing with all your settings. Now, this is actually displaying the actual temperature inside the car, not the temperature it's set at. Although it's set at 77, that's not what I had it at. I had it at, won't let me. Oh, turn that off. And now it will let me turn it back up. A little cool out today. Let's go back to release notes. So that is very, very cool. Previous release notes, blind spot collision warning chime. You can now turn on an audible chime to warn you when a possible collision with a vehicle or obstacle is detected in your target lane. I do not have this on. I hate chimes. I'm fine with the normal alerts. Auto folding mirrors based on location. This one's also new for me. Your car can now automatically fold and unfold the side mirrors based on location. Saves you from having to manually position your mirrors each time you arrive at leave a frequented place, such as narrow garages, tight parking spaces, etc. Now, personally, auto-folding mirrors are great, but I'm starting to have issues with them on my Model S. About a year ago, actually, but I'm out of warranty. So I actually disabled fold mirrors on park. And now I only fold manually when I absolutely need to, or if I am going to be parking on the street. Cold weather, and I actually, there's a nice bug with cold weather already, and something that I'd love it if they'd fix, or I should say not with cold weather works fine, but it's how the controls are. For a quicker, more intuitive experience in the cold weather and climate control settings, cold weather and climate control settings have been combined into a single view. Touch the fan icon to access settings for climate control, as well as all seat heaters, steering wheel heater, and the wiper heater. Now, I'm going to turn up my HVAC fan here. I'm sure you guys can all hear it now, because I'm going to demonstrate something. I'm going to shut my seat heater off. Let's shut that off. Okay. So, let's just say now, I don't want my HVAC on, my heat or air conditioning, but I want to turn on either my cooled or heated seats, because this car, as far as I'm aware, I got the perforated leather seats in this car, so mine cool and heat. So, I'd have to touch this to bring up the menu, but watch what happens. As soon as I touch the button to bring up the menu, it automatically turns on my fan. I'm going to turn that back down to whatever setting I had before. So now say you're going to be doing a drive where it was going to be a tight squeeze on power, getting between superchargers maybe, and you don't want your HVAC on, but you can do just fine with your seat heater. Well, by touching that just to turn on the seat heater, the ventilation controls come on. Now, obviously, for the front passenger and driver, you can use the controls here. But say you wanted to turn on one of the back passengers. As soon as I bring up that menu, the front HVAC turns on. Oof. Now, say I just wanted to do the rear HVAC for the Model X here. I want rear, but I don't want front. So rear's on. Now, every time I touch it, the front still comes on, but maybe I don't want front. So this is a nasty bug that really needs to get squashed. You can't touch anything in this menu without the front heat or air conditioning controls coming on. And that is really, really annoying. Oh, let's turn off the back because there's nobody back there. No point in turning that off. Okay, back to release notes. Quite a bit of lag loading the release notes on this one. Navigate on autopilot beta. Now, this I did have. And navigate on autopilot. Granny, of course. Suggests lane changes. Now, I don't have the confirmationless navigate on autopilot, which started rollouts to vehicles this week, but it has not made it this far yet. Now, I don't know if that's going to be on autopilot 2.5 and higher cars, or if I might actually be able to get that on my autopilot 2 car. Either way, eventually I'm supposed to get some sort of computer chip upgrade to autopilot version 3 or full self-drive computer chip. So doesn't need too much explaining. The car automatically suggests a better lane to be in based on traffic if one lane's moving faster than my set speed, and or if I need to be in a different lane to be able to take a exit or turnpike or so on and so on. Now, right now, to change lanes, I would have to either touch the turn signal to confirm that I agree and change the lane, or pull the autopilot stalk in to confirm. And that's where what I am going to go do a demo on after this. Once again, I'm going to do the Navigate on Autopilot demo, and I'm also going to be doing a stoplight demo. And that is all. Once again, this was for Firmware 9, release 2019.8.4. Awesome! Or is it? What are your thoughts on this new firmware release? Let me know in the description box below. Don't forget, like and subscribe. And if you haven't yet, also subscribe to my Facebook page, as I am able to do much more frequent small text updates without having to make a video for every thought in the world.